He's on.
Dr. Hornig. Hello?
Yes, Doctor.
Well, Mr. President?
Yes.
Just thought you ought to be informed about the technical situation in the New England area.
Yes.
At the moment, it's still unclear, but this, you know, what happened is that a great storm started in the...
Wait just a second, Doctor. Let me cut this music off here.
Yes.
Go ahead now.
I said it started in the area of the Niagara Mohawk Power Company. But at this point, which is near Syracuse, but at this point, they still don't know exactly what failed. Then as their load was transmitted to neighboring companies, what happens with the interties is that the power companies went out like dominoes. You see, as each one transmitted its demands from the failure to the next one, it overloaded the next facilities, and so on and so on. The present situation is, however, that Niagara Falls is generating again, as is Messina, and so power is coming into upstate New York. I have talked also to Connecticut and Edison, and they are, within the next hour, expect to have some power in New York, and a reasonable amount within 3 hours. But it seems fairly clear that it's going to be, all of the power companies are now isolating themselves from each other, so the fault is that there's a big startup problem. And it's apparently going to be a number of hours before power is can be restored. I have been in contact with Secretary McNamara and with the FTC. I wondered, is there anything further I can do for you?
No, I want you to tell Bill Moyers in detail. Do you have any reason, the cause of it?
They have not been out. The latest information I have is that they have not been able to isolate the initial cause.
What everybody wonders about sabotage, and we want to clear that if we can.
I will keep after that with the Niagara Mohawk Power Company. It seems fairly clear it was within the area of the Niagara Mohawk Power Company.
Are there any reason to believe that they sabotaged?
I know of no reason at the moment. There was heavy thunderstorm activity in the area, and it might have to do with that, but there's no evidence.
When I tell Bill Moyers, you don't know what caused it, but there was a heavy thunderstorm area. There could be a connection there, that all possible things are being examined, and then give him any other details you can so he can keep this group of panicked people informed.
I will do that, sir.
Now, wait a minute. Let me transfer you to him.
Operator.
Transfer this call to Bill Moyer, Dr. Hornig, to Bill Moyer in Austin.
Thank you, sir.
And stay with him until you get him on.
Yes, sir.
Mr. President?
Yes?
Before I leave you, I must tell you the one amusing episode in this dreadful experience, which is that Bob McNamara called me at about 6 o'clock, and the only authentic information I had to give him, and he had none of his own, as to what was going on, had come from my wife, who would watch TV. I think we have some very serious lessons to learn from this.
Yes, well, I heard it on CBS radio broadcast. In my car phone, I called California and asked him to call McNamara and Buford Ellington, all of them, and put them on it, and he hadn't heard it.
Yes, well, that was probably when Bob called me.
Yes, I think I must have been the first one to heard it. Here, let me give it to you, Bill.
All right. Operator?
Give this to Bill Moyers and stay on till you get him, and wherever Bill is, see that Dr. Hornig connected.
Yes, sir, I will. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
One moment, Dr. Hornig.
All right.
Right.